session, submission of bills and claims. Anybody have any questions on that? Please don't, you're asking the administrator, if not, to go forward with engineering. Sorry, Mike.
Okay. Hi, good evening. Item 1A is a discussion on the proposal for a sidewalk from Continental Soldiers Park going southbound on Route 202 towards the culvert where the counties are replacing, currently replacing the culvert. We got an estimate from the contractor. It would be about $45,000. We reviewed the amount available in the town sidewalk fund, which is about $35,000. If we wanted to do this as part of their contract, we would have to come up with the additional funds. We do expect two applicants to post about $10,000 each by the end of the year into the sidewalk fund, but I don't know when that would be put into place. I provide you with our August 7th letter. In there, it sketches the location of the proposed sidewalk. Now, I have had discussions with Ed Vidal, who's the executive director of the New Jersey Trail Conference. He wanted to be present to review this with the council as well. I received an email from him at 3:30 today saying that due to family illness or something that he couldn't make it tonight. He asked if he'd be available, or he asked if he could discuss it with the council at a future meeting. So I don't think we need to necessarily take any action tonight. Really just want to review this with you. The county's out there doing the job now. They're going to be out there for, you know, until the end of October. But I think we should provide them with our direction probably within the next few weeks.
We did review this with Ed Goodell, Mike and I, and we would want you to consider this because that sidewalk services Rampo College students over the new culvert into the trail conference, and otherwise it's a sidewalk to nowhere because there are accommodations on the new culvert for this sidewalk. So when they get a chance to consider it, we hope that you do that favorably.
And I know that there's some people right now that wish that there was a sidewalk from there all the way down to the Continental Soldiers right now with the road closed.
Well, it would go. In fact, it does go from Continental, correct?
It's just going to go from Continental Soldiers Park to basically the New Jersey Trail Conference.
Yeah.
Right.
It doesn't go the other way.
What I'm saying is there's some people with the road closed right now who are walking down from the park.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then our other item is the my written status report. I'd just like to touch on a few items. The Lake Bluff Ave project's going very well. The water main and sewer main have been installed. They just have to install the laterals. We expect them to be done in about 2 weeks. For MA1680, that's the Nielsen Ave emergency generator, Nielsen Avenue pump station emergency generator project. We expect to advertise next week and receive bids beginning in September, and we'll look to have that awarded at a September council meeting. For MA1695, that's the town's road program. We've advertised in the paper. We did get DOT comments back. We advertised in the paper August 1st. We're going to receive bids next Wednesday, and we'll look to award that project at the next council meeting. And then the Route 202 detour culvert project's going well. That detour has been in place. The county is in the process of paving east and west Rampo Ave. I would like to acknowledge the administrator. He was key to get the county to stay on this project. There was a point where the county had indicated that due to a number of items that they were going to have to skip this section of roadway. And Quinn did a great job at pushing them and continuing to be on them to get them to do that. Because as we know, East Rampo Ave, West Rampo Ave is in really, really poor condition. And we explained that to the county, and they're doing that work speak, and that should work should be done by the end of the day tomorrow. And that's
gentle
all I have.
Persuasion on behalf of the business manager.
Yes.
Good job, Quinn.
And that's all I have.
Okay. Anybody have any questions? Anything on the verbal status? Anything? Mike, thank you for everything you do, thank you, everything you've been through, for, you know, what's going on.
No problem, take care, good night.
Thanks, Mike.
Usually it's footsteps.
Administration.
Okay, several items under administration this evening, item 2A is a resolution that's being circulated by the League of Municipalities, I believe, and it's urging the state legislature to extend the 2% cap on police and fire arbitration contract awards. Of course, since there is a very stringent 2% cap on tax levy increases that applies to municipalities, you have to restrain everything else in your budget, and so we're asking that the council consider approving that.
I have a question.
Okay.
Why does the police and fire, why not everybody?
Well, because that's the status of the law now. Since police and fire can actually go to interest arbitration and other bargaining units cannot, so the law that was put in place several years ago set a 2% cap on what arbitrators can award in those cases. So right now the other bargaining groups don't have the ability to go to arbitration.
Anybody else have any questions?
Okay. Okay, 2B, it's just chapter 159 to add some revenue to your budget. The revenue is from the Clean Communities Grant, $50,553.10 from the State of New Jersey Solid Waste Administration, and it will be added to the 2017 budget. And this money must be used for clean community and recycling purposes.
Anybody have any questions on that? 2C?
Okay, 2C, this is a good housekeeping. Each year, your CFO sells notes for a certain debt that we have outstanding. He just did the note sale for this year. The notes mature in 1 year, so the maturity date will be August 3rd of 2018. The principal amount was $15,250,000. There were five bids. We had very aggressive bidding, and the net interest cost is 1.109%. The winning bidder or the low bidder was TD Securities, and that's the report. There's a requirement in the law that this has to be reported and reflected in the minutes of the meeting.
Any questions on that?
Okay, 2D, we have a resolution 206-17. Last year, at about this time, the township adopted a resolution with regard to the Pilgrim Pipeline, and the resolution really did two things. Number one, it authorized the township to join the Municipal Pipeline Alliance to oppose the Pilgrim Pipeline, and it also awarded a contract to the law firm Currency Hollenbeck to do some environmental legal work in connection with the pipeline. They've been working on that. There were three items in the retainer agreement that was proposed at that time, and just in an oversight, the resolution was actually adopted last year. Only covered two of the items. It was always the intent to cover all three items. So the resolution should be amended. The original award amount was $7,600. It should be amended to $11,800.
Anybody have any questions? Seeing none.
Okay, 2E is a proposed ordinance. This is a bit of housekeeping. Several years ago, actually almost 10 years ago, State of New Jersey adopted legislation to reform several elements of the New Jersey pension system. Public employees generally are members of pension systems that are not tied to the township, but tied to the state of New Jersey. The New
Jersey creates the pension system, sets the pension rules, and requires that employees, depending upon their terms of employment, are members of one pension system or another. 10 years ago, there was the creation of a new retirement program called the Defined Contribution Retirement Program, and it applies to certain limited classes of employees. It was a requirement shortly thereafter that the township adopt an ordinance classifying various employees into this retirement program. The ordinance was never adopted. We're cleaning it up and asking you to adopt the ordinance now. It follows a model ordinance that was created by the state of New Jersey and that almost every other community in New Jersey has adopted. No harm done here. The rules have been followed assiduously since the beginning of this program. Pension enrollments here are handled by the finance department. We've reviewed this with the CFO, and the language of the ordinance is appropriate for what we've been doing right along. So we're asking you to introduce that on first reading and schedule a public hearing for your next meeting.
Anybody have any questions?
Okay, and then the last item is Bergen County Community Development Appointments. The county looks for appointments from the council and then also an appointment from the mayor. And at the beginning of the year, the council made appointments of course, Council President Hermanson and Councilwoman Arima. However, because I'm sure this has to do with the nature of the federal government, rather than have appointments from January 1st to December 31st, they'd like the appointments to run from July 1st to June 30th of the following year. So we're asking that such a resolution be adopted this evening. And also in that resolution, it recognizes that the mayor is appointing myself with Rich Wolf as a backup before his appointments. I will.
Can we make a recommendation to them they don't do it on Thursday nights and at our council meetings again?
Well, they did that. They did it twice. Somebody's going to have to play hooky if that happens.
Very difficult.
Yeah, that's hard.
Can't be in two places.
The last time I met, there was a bunch of business administrators there.
Yeah, oh yeah. I mean, typically, you know, this is often done by the business administrators.
Okay, anyone have any questions with that? Okay, 3A. Township Council Facebook page discussion. There you go. Mr. May?
I think the last time we discussed this, we said we needed a resolution.
Yes. Also, I think one of the discussions, though, is also that why don't we talk about for posting and, you know, make sure that, you know, how we're going to do that this way that I think the public would understand, and also maybe for administration and how we're going to set that up and go from there.
Okay. Who do we think should be the poster?
Well, I think anybody right now should be able to put on something so long as it goes through that it's not, you know, you're not putting the controversial thing, you're putting an announcement or whatever. I think anybody should be able to do some of that stuff.
Okay.
But I don't think that we should be, you know, putting our own opinions or anything on there. There should be no opinions, no anything. It really should be more of informative things and comments. I think comments like on this, as the public was telling us tonight, there might be things that were stated from the attorney that, you know, on certain issues or things that we can put up so that people have enough, you know, you can follow what we're saying, and this way it's gone through the legal side of it without us making the comment ourselves. I think that makes the most sense. But I think if there's an event or things that are happening in town, Mawa Day and discussion of that, and panel day, things like that we've seen in town. I think some of those things make sense. Even the discussion right now that we, you know, on some of these other, some of the meetings that we have, some of the meetings that come forward.
Right.
I think that should be all on. Yes, Janet.
Well, like our packet, like
the city to my left. Because, again, that's going to be something that you won't want from a public
Ryan, side. You have time to run our Facebook page?
Mr. Wong is going to be an attorney.
Yeah, but it still doesn't make a difference.
He's our
town attorney.
The township attorney is going to put out whatever we said to make sure that whatever we say is that's going to be on there is good and clean, so we don't have to worry about going through the proper processes. It makes the most sense, but again, it's I don't think it's going to be anything.
Could always get Brian if I write something. I could always get Brian.
When we do it at the ordinance committee meeting, I can put it up afterwards and say, try to get it to go from there.
The resolution would pass the social media policy. Is that what the resolution is? Because it's not an ordinance, right?
No, you would just
resolution just approving it.
Approve the use of a council Facebook page.
Yep.
You previously discussed how the administration of that page would work, that there would be any comments that you have. And that the posting would be basically council as a whole dealing with it, so that there wouldn't be individual posts. That's where we were at.
Right. Okay. Should we consider, January 1st, maybe just the committee, so that we can appoint individuals at the beginning of the year? Should we consider just making it a committee? So, just an ad hoc committee or something, so that one January 1st rolls around each year, we appoint the individual council members.
We could do something. Well, we could do it, and that's not a bad idea. You may want to do something with a social media committee or something like that, or this way you put it. So,
right, don't we have a social media or media policy that has to be adopted first?
Well, you have a draft of, I keep pulling that mic. You have a draft of the social media policy that I believe Quentin circulated. You also have a social media policy. To a limited extent in your personnel policies.
This will be on the agenda also for Tuesday, so it's something, policies, something in addition that needs to be reviewed.
Yeah, we're not adopting this tonight.
Yeah, that
so it's good. So this will be up for the next, for discussion for both of you at the same time at the next meeting.
Okay.
Right?
I was just going to say that social media policy, that bears review.
Yeah.
It's not a trivial policy to put some burdens on people, you should understand the ramifications of that when you read it. That policy, as written, by the way, would apply to everybody associated with the township, mm-hmm. including volunteers and employees and everything else. So you need to read that and decide how far you want to go. That follows a joint insurance fund template. It's obviously something that you
demand. I just thought Brian's got another job. So basically that's fine. We should do that. We have the two ordinance committee meetings that we're looking to schedule over the next 2 weeks anyhow. So we can put that on there for the first meeting. And then this way, if there's anything that comes about from that needs to be followed up or brushed up, we can have it set to schedule for the following meeting when we move forward before we actually come back to the next council meeting on the 24th.
Yes.
Makes sense? Good administration on that? Good.
Well, Quentin will also be at the meeting. So
yeah. Great. Okay. 3B. 3B is a special event.
Can you go back to the Facebook page? I have one more question. What about streaming the Facebook page? Is that part of this?
I think that's what we were talking about, that we would go on to the Facebook page and we started to stream, that we would put it to our council page as opposed to...
Okay.
Now, that doesn't stop any from streaming on their own page,
too. That's
fine.
But,
but it will be...
People can do what they want on their own page, but I think that we should be...
Right, but what I'm saying is we're going to have to come up with something here then to do that. We have to come up with a way of... Right now, Dave is using his iPad.
Right, but Dave is putting it on his own personal.
Right,
Facebook.
But he can still do that if he wanted to. What
right.
I'm saying is we're going to have to come up with our own iPad then for the council to do it.
And actually, it doesn't cost that much.
I'm just telling you, we're going to have to do that, which means we have to fund it. But
how much is
the iPad? I don't know if we have the extra ones in town right now, but we can look into that. That's something that can be settled, I think, before the next council meeting.
Well, yeah, I think that when we discuss the Facebook page, we should also discuss
potential company to help Mahwah Community News, and there'd be a streaming aspect that they would provide, which I think could probably be fed into the council page or whoever else would want it on their page. So I think, I don't even know that we would need another iPad. I think it might be handled. If you wanted to do that for now, if we had an extra one.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
I think overall, there's going to be, my guess is in the future, there's going to be equipment that's going to be able to handle all that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
But we can talk about that now.
Okay, special events permit, Dead Man's Curves LLC. I'm going to let Mr. White, Mr. Wysock, do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, what I know.
I guess that's Labor Day weekend.
Yeah, it's car show.
It's probably one of the biggest car shows in the on the East Coast. I urge everybody, excuse me, if you get a chance to attend it, it's probably one of the coolest things you'll see in a long time. This year they have a jet funny car that they're going to light up the skies. In order to have it, they request the fire department to be there because it's really a spectacle to see. And I really think it'll be great for the town.
Any musical guests?
We were going to have Leonard Skinner play, but I was invited today that they're going to be away for that weekend. So next year. Next year.
Okay.
Where is
it? It's going to be at the Crossroads, Cherry Crossroads bracket.
When?
Labor Day weekend.
August 31st through September 3rd, 9 a.m. to 10 p.m.
Thank you.
Okay, anybody have any questions on that? Next two are pretty simple. You got, I'm 3C, a firefighter application for Anthony and Al Donna from Fire Company Number 2. Anybody have any questions on Mr. Al Donna? And I want to thank him for volunteering for his service. Also, for 3D, firefighter application, Nicholas S. Biondi as a daytime member to company, again, Fire Company Number 2. Again, I want to thank him for his service. Anybody have any questions on that? Okay, that brings us to our public meeting. We're not going to have a break for the public meeting. We'll go straight through. We bring it to approval of bills and claims. Roll call.
Mrs. Rima?
Yes.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Abstain.
Mr. Mahon?
Yes.
Mr. Vasaki?
Yes.
Mr. Hermes?
Yes. Okay, approval of meeting minutes, combined work session and public meeting minutes from July 13th and the closed session of July 27th. Can I get a motion?
Motion.
Motion by Mr. May. Second by Mr. Wysock. Roll call.
Ms. Rima?
Yes to July 13th and abstain July 27th.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Yes.
Mr. Wong?
Yes.
Mr. Vasaki?
Yes.
Mr. Hermanson?
Yes, both. Okay, reports of the Township Council, Municipal Clerk, Township Council comments, communication reports of subcommittees. Again, this meeting has gone a little longer than we normally have. I'm going to ask that we try to keep our comments and our council comments. I'm sorry, I know you've been out, you missed the last meeting, but I'm just saying if we can try to keep it within 5 minutes for each person.
Wait a minute. People get to come up here and talk for five minutes, and I can't? No, I have to do my report, okay? So, all right. The library.
Roll call.
Yeah, okay. We knew you were directing it at me, so.
And no, I'm directing it all.
No, you were directing it at me.
You want to go home, right?
All right, call me. Okay. Mr. Rima, okay. The Library Board of Trustees has no meetings in July and August. Next meeting's September 20, but I just wanted to say, everybody here is aware that they will be sponsoring the Candidates Night. Meet the Candidates Night will be on Thursday, October 19th at 7:30 at the Mahwah Senior Center. So if you want to see the candidates running for council, you can go there. Access for All, the last meeting was canceled. But I wanted to say that they are concerned about transportation. I spoke with Dot recently in Access Transportation, and I found that we have 3 grants for new vans, but those grants are replacing existing vans. We're not getting any new vans. And the problem that the Access for All people are having is that the vans that we have obtained are through grants, and they can't transport seniors or the disabled if the transport isn't health or food related. So they can't get to the senior center if the senior center is serving lunch, but they can get to the Bergen County Senior Center in Midland Park because they do serve lunch. So right now they're trying to work on a way that maybe the senior center here can somehow be considered a place that serves lunch so that the vans can transport our seniors to our own senior center. More to come on that because they're working on that. The Environmental Commission met last night. As you heard, they had the presentation here today about the rain garden. It's going to be beautiful, and it's opening a mile a day. Suez made a presentation last night. The mayor and the business administrator were also there about our wells. Right now, we have our tanks are under contract, and they're under a maintenance contract, so we maintain our tanks. But we're not maintaining our wells with a contract. If something happens, we call someone up and we get it fixed. But what they were giving us a presentation on is our well maintenance contract. They are going to be coming here to this council with the presentation. It's a short 15-minute presentation. It's very well done. It explains everything very well. But I just wanted to say that what they're asking from us is that we get this maintenance contract. It's going to cost us, I think it's $1 million over 10 years, I think it was. Is that correct? Was it about a million over 10 years?
Yeah, it's about that.
Yeah, but they're saying we need to do that because we don't want to lose our wells. And the problem is that we have old wells, four Ford wells and three wells in Lumber 202, and they're getting older. And what happens is he explains it very well that there's screens inside the wells, and what happens is the screens get clogged, and they call it plugging. And it gets clogged from bacterial buildup and barn sediment. And so what they're going to do is they're going to come and they're going to make sure that they clean all the filters in the wells. And they're also going to maintain our pumps. Like if something happens to the pump, part of the contract will be that they will replace the pump for us. So our wells will, and they're going to guarantee the flow in the well. So they're going to set a bench point on each well, and if the flow is whatever it is, they're going to guarantee that flow is going to keep up, and they're going to keep that well producing the same amount. So you're going to see that presentation. I thought it was a great idea. I think something we're going to need it. We're going to have to do it because we don't want anything to happen to our wells. And the other thing that was brought up at the Environmental Commission is the dumping on Stag Hill again. MIMO is going to be back to the Environmental Commission. They're coming up with proposals on how to handle the dumping up at Stag Hill, but they're not done with that yet. On MAWA Day, the theme is going to be the dumping at Stag Hill, and the Environmental Commission plans to bring in 45 tires to MAWA Day in the booth, and just to show people, I think they said they took out was it 6,000 tires or something so far? But they're going to bring 45 of them and put them there in Mile Day to show people this is the stuff that's getting dumped up at Stag Hill. And they're saying right now what's happening is they get rid of all the dumping, and then people, it's mainly contractor waste, like job site, building, construction waste. And people are coming up there and dumping.
Listen, I wouldn't mind doing, I've done that twice now, we've been up there with my volunteers and myself. I wouldn't mind doing a day with the council going up there. And
yeah, can we? I think we should.
I'm being honest.
I want to go up there too. I keep telling Eric. Eric says so he'll bring us up there.
Reach out to him and see if there's something we could do.
The council up there.
I thought we maybe be able to go to our families or volunteers and maybe do something here, or even in the township, maybe do as a townwide, something on the event, maybe on a weekend.
Well, he told me that he wants to show me where all this stuff is.
Listen, I've been there, I've spent 2 full days, myself and others.
So you want to help get rid of it or anything?
Listen,
okay,
I'll tell him. He knows their farming.
What about the beautification committee? Do they have to clean up?
No,
beautification used to do cleanup in the spring at the right before baseball season over at a Continental, but yeah. I don't think that happens this year. We will look at that again to talk to the committee for next year.
Yeah.
One, two more things. One more thing. For the signs and the cameras, are we getting them or are they there on Stag Hill?
They're a part of a community grant, and Glenn is looking into that.
So, because they're getting very frustrated because they're saying that we're not doing anything to stop the dumping. And I said last night, yes, we are. We're getting the signs and the cameras. And they said, well, so they're upset because they keep getting rid of the stuff and they're saying we're not supporting.
I understand their frustration. The problem is, again, is that you have to catch the person who's actually doing it and when they're doing it and when it happens.
Right.
Okay? Which is the reason why you're looking towards the cameras.
Right.
If you listen to the administration, one of the things that we did look into then is to try to figure out a way to do that through the grant. Hopefully, we'll be able to have that rectified soon, and that'll be taken care of, and we might be able to take care of some of the problems that they have. But, you know, you can only go as fast as we can do some things.
Okay. Well, that's my report.
Thank you.
How many minutes?
I didn't time you.
Oh, you didn't time me?
I should have, though, but I
didn't know.
Much it's much better than usual.
Okay. I was on vacation, so I really have a good report. The only thing I asked, several residents did approach me about an additional sign, the no left turn on the corner of Brook by the vacuum cleaner store. I know a lot of going on in town, so I just want to remind you of that. And that's it. That's my report.
Yeah, the only thing I have to report is just to touch a little bit more on the webinar we had on Monday. In regards to increasing our ability to show the meetings, these meetings and other meetings on our TV channel and then also streaming it on the web. I want to thank Quentin for connecting us with the company. I thought their suite of products was amazing. Just an example, they can break the video of the meeting down into segments just based on our agenda, and they do all that on the back end. I think some cool stuff that hopefully we can bring to all the residents in short order. And that is my report.
Mr. Wong.
I know it's the day has passed, but I just wanted to wish Councilman Irvin a very happy birthday.
Thank you.
The ordinance committee will be meeting, will be having 2 meetings very shortly. And then at the last council meeting, I actually made a misstatement, which I would like the attorney to correct.
Yeah, I believe Councilman Wong indicated that the ordinance committee meetings were public meetings. They are not. They are committee meetings, which are less than the body of a whole, and can also are less than a quorum. So the committee meetings are designed in order to get the information to invite, I guess, department heads also with respect to the ordinance committee to address, in order that, you know, these issues can be worked out, and then the ordinance committee will bring whatever recommendations are to the body that will be discussed publicly.
That is my report.
I've been away on vacation and business for the last 2 weeks, so I really don't have a big report. I was approached by several residents down in the West Ward area of Meadow Ave, Long Ave, and the question came up, is it possible that the council can look in the right direction, possibly making all those intersections on Meadow before we stop?
Done that.
Well, we've looked into it. Doesn't necessarily mean that we're done it. It's something, again, that will be talked about after the stop sign with the no left one up, was that we were going to see how that worked.
Okay.
And to come back and evaluate it again to see how things were going in the neighborhood. I would ask that, you know, one of the things that, you know, we find out how we can, what, you know, I know someone who lives on Catherine. You know, you can tell me what your thoughts may be, or let us know, and, you know, going forward in the next meeting. us an idea of...
Right, yeah, I'll reach out to everyone in the neighborhood.
I think that would be a good idea.
But that's all I have.
Okay, I'm going to go try to go as quick as possible here, too. I had a meeting, obviously, on Friday that I had talked about earlier, along with myself, the mayor, the business administrator, chief, Mr. Chikowski, and we went through some things that were going on here with some of our ordinances to discuss of how we can do things better and whatnot. I think it was an excellent meeting, which then led me to have another meeting along with the chief, which I think also was very, very productive, and one that I think that we had for suggestions and open dialogue. We talked about having a potential representative from PBA to come in to sit down with us at our, to come in and give us issues that might be going on there to talk. And then go back and forth so that if there was an issue inside that we would know what was happening. That was brought up at our meeting on Friday. And it was, basically went further. We also talked about having individuals at our, for our ordinance meetings to have someone from the police department in on those meetings if there's going to be something that we're going to have to enforce or ask the law enforcement community to do. That we only think it's fair that they would have a say in how it would be done. And we would ask that they would be part of the communication so that we could open dialogue and have a fair dialogue between everybody. It was a good meeting. I think it went well for everybody, and I think that anything that has a suggestion, as I stated to the chief, that any dialogue that has from PBA that they would like us to hear, talk to us. I think there's ways of doing this. I think communication is good. When you have lack of communication, I think it causes a lot of problems. And hopefully that will go forward. We can fix some of the issues. I had this on my phone and going through, but I want to congratulate our pool, Jay Esposito, who is our head of our pool. That this year in 2017 we were awarded the Distinguished Facility Award, which is a tremendous honor for the pools and what they've done and the people where we have done in our community. The Whistle Stop, which also is our a new. This is the first year for them as a our snack providers and food and provide for lunches and things. Were fantastic. The reviews from people on them is phenomenal. Hopefully we'll have them again next year, which is great. We did very well with the championships for our swim team and our dive, and coming in fourth overall and third, which was good. And so I congratulate our coaches and people who were there, our kids and teaching our kids. I also noticed that in the Bergen Record that we also had Bergen Record does a look for 50 seniors stars to come forward. One of the ones that was brought up was a young lady here from town, Lauren Stern, for a track star. So again, another great thing here for the town to see, and wonderful people that are our athletes. Good luck to her in this upcoming year. It's great stuff. The last couple things is one I just asked that see Mr. Sabari here soon again, and it's good stuff. Hopefully good things are going to happen there. And I want to congratulate my niece. At the last meeting I told you that what was going on was we were waiting for my niece to have my mother's first great grandchild, and she did. And it was a little girl, which is, made everybody very, very happy. But the last thing I have is, as I see people here in the audience, and I see people up here on this dais, some of us are having one of our children heading off to college. I want to congratulate those kids who have been tremendous success for them and look forward to their future successes in the near future and come back to Mahwah and be part of the community and be part of the fact they're here to help us become who we are and continue to who we are in this town. Like I said, I congratulate them for their successes. And Mr. Wysocki and Mr. Irvin, I see Mrs. He's hiding back there, Mrs. Steinberg, and Mrs. Conley, they're all, the kids who are going back, and going to school, I congratulate them and look forward to their successes. Thank you. That's good.
Thank you.
Yes, also the, I echo what Dave has talked about. Swagat is the vendor for potentially filming and streaming these cameras and these meetings, and I think it was a very good presentation. It was a little lengthy, but it, well, a lot of good information comes out of there. So we're looking forward to getting some more information and getting a price. We didn't get a price, but I think it's well worth the adventure. You know, we can't help but mention a very dear friend, Bob LaMontagne, who is a fireman, Board of Health. He did pretty much everything you can imagine in this town for a very, very long time, passed away. And he will be missed. His family are wonderful, very active in this community. So I know we all will send our best condolences to the family. On a different note, you know, police officers are, you know, we sometimes take for granted the very things that they do every day. And we think about the risks that they take are really the major risks. And today, this morning, a very innocent minor event. With the paving that's going on, we have a special detail of officers on scene, and one motorist, we won't tell you who that is, decided that he wanted to disobey the officer's commands to not proceed, continue to proceed, and injured the officer. He was subsequently arrested. The officer's okay. He's in good shape, and he's, you know, as we know that all of our officers are built for speed, you know, and they're durable. But I point out that we don't take time enough to realize even the most innocent acts that these police officers expose themselves to can be detrimental. I know there's a few of you here, and we thank you very much for your service, and hopefully our community decides to listen to officers a little more here. But that's my report. I'll keep it short, and thank you very much.
Mr. Reed?
Okay, some items that have already been commented on. Council President did comment on the Board of Education process, and I did confirm with the Business Administrator of the Board of Ed that their August 30th meeting, they do have Verizon coming in, and we'll be talking about cell phone service, the possibility of installing a monopole at the athletic field up by Seacourt Farm. The second thing, several people have commented about the webinar that we did have to get people introduced to the capability of outside company to stream these meetings and other content to the general public. I'd like to offer that opportunity to other members of the council. Councilman May did partake the other day, but if other members of the council would like to do that, and we'd like to get some of the other members of the cable committee. In the course of the next week, we'll set up another one, and maybe what I'll do is I'll send out a couple of times and see who's able to participate and what kind of response I get. But maybe next week we'll set something up. Takes about an hour, and you get to see several operating websites from other communities that have this service in place, and great capability there. And I think it's something you'll be interested in. Last but not least, speaking of the police department, we were notified that we did receive a grant award. This grant comes around periodically, and we were the recipients of a grant award for Drive Sober or Get Pulled Over Labor Day Crackdown. So this grant, when it comes in, it pays for a certain number of hours of police overtime to get out and do DWI crackdowns, and it's important and saves lives. So we're happy to get that, and we'll be out there in the near future. And that's my report. Thank you.
I just want to add one thing I forgot to mention. As we were talking about, you know, people, we also down at the Senior Center lost a very good person, Peter Rosanna. Anyone who knows, anyone who's served lunch or has been down there as from the council or whatever, has been in the kitchen, knows that Peter was the one who helped get us situated and who was serving where and where we were going and what tables to. Served down at the Senior Center for actually for 14 years since it opened. He was a volunteer, and he was in charge, like I said, of the kitchen, the coffee station, he did all that. And so it's my condolences to his family, his daughter, his grandchildren, and his wife during this during the loss. And he really
great guy, he really was, and, you know, it's a township Mawa's loss. Okay, this, now we're back to the public portion, the second public portion. Again, we are, this one is for 30 minutes. Public portion will be limited to 5 minutes for each speaker. Each speaker shall provide name and address before speaking. Mawa residents shall speak first. This public portion is limited to subjects that is now on basically pretty much anything. The public portion shall be maximum of 30 minutes. And like I said, it's a Mawa residents first.
Good evening, TJ Rinaldi, State Street. I just want to say that I think the last meeting, Mr. Hermanson and Mrs. Navi, I think is from your firm.
Correct.
I think they did an outstanding job. Based on the circumstances, I don't think they could have done any better. So if you could just let her know that, I appreciate that, that we did appreciate what she did here and what she said. And then, is it safe to assume that tonight we're still not allowed to speak about Eru religion, specifically anti-Semitism, or anything related to a specific group?
I'm going to leave that to the attorney. The attorney can make that comment.
I would prefer that there not be any discussion of any specific groups or the like. This town has been threatened with litigation, and statements can be used against the community.
Okay. I appreciate that, and I hope that the rest of the meeting goes well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Vicki Gallo, G-A-L-O-W, 68 Armour Road. I wanted to just request, when you're developing your social media policy, that you consider all forms of communication on the web, that Facebook is not the only form of communication. A lot of people do not go on Facebook. I have quite a lot of friends of mine who don't. And I was wondering what other avenues you're considering. Have you thought about YouTube as a place to put your council meetings to stream? And have you considered your website? What's happening with that? Are you is that a place to put links or to put to be able to have streaming?
I think right now that would be something we would have to sit down and talk to Dino about. Who's our IT guy. I think anything, as we've said, we're going through this as a process of when we get, trying to get the cameras in here for
yes.
To do the meetings.
Mm-hmm.
I think once that's established, then I think anything is possible. And all options are open for anything to go anywhere.
Excellent.
I don't know that at that point. It's just a matter, again, of making sure that we do it right and it's put up properly and how we take care of it.
But so while you're developing your policy, so that's where I'm at. Please focus on all aspects, not just, limited.
No, I absolutely agree with that. I think that's one of the things, and I credit Mr. May for that as being on the cable
mm-hmm.
committee. That was one of the things that has been brought forth to us that this has been discussed to try to get this done.
Dave, did you say you were meeting the cable committee's meeting?
Yeah, it should be meeting, I think next week. They're on the meeting. I just wanted to touch on
mm-hmm.
your question. Not to be repetitive, but this webinar we had on Monday. The company,
you already had a webinar? Did
we
you
had
say?
A webinar,
oh,
yeah, with the company.
Oh, I thought it was coming up, I'm sorry.
They provide, actually, they build a TV channel basically into the website, which is great. It's really cool, and I would encourage everyone, if you can
mm-hmm.
get onto that webinar, it'd be beneficial.
That would be a good place for it.
But, I think YouTube is another option.
Mm-hmm.
I think we just have to hone in on the social media policy.
I was here last time and we talked about it, and it's true sometimes, you put everything out there and people still aren't getting the message.
Yeah.
So I understand
yeah.
that that's always is an issue. But at this point in time, it's just very important that people are notified. And that woman who spoke earlier really touched upon the me that, you know, people really aren't not informed. We're not, you know, a lot of the people are not.
I'm not trying to joke about this, honestly, but I'm telling you that the amount of phone calls that I have received over the last 4 weeks, I'm telling you that there's a lot of people who are informed.
But sometimes misinformed.
I don't mean that. I'm just saying that it's just,
But there's misinformation.
Absolutely. And that's why we talked about how we need to have
the information that comes. I respect that very much.
You know, because there's only so much that can get out.
Yes. May I ask one more question?
Sure.
I appreciate so much that you are working with Jim Telly and that you're working, that everyone's working together to, you know, get along. That is fantastic for our town. It's very important. In just general terms, how does the communication usually go with the chief? Does he contact you, you know, when he wants to inform you of something, or do you? Was this a time when, you know, it was?
So that I'm going to get to the way it works, the way it worked, or the way we hope
how
it worked.
How does it usually work?
That there was no communication.
Now, how does it usually work? Like, does the chief reach out to you?
I'm trying to tell you that there was no. All right, because the way the Faulkner says is that unless
is
the chief,
Faulkner
was a former governor,
yes.
And so because the former governor we're in, the only way that the council can directly contact the chief is through the mayor. And that means that any question I have generally goes through the mayor, gets filtered through the mayor, any answers get back, goes filtered back through the mayor to us. No direct, direct contact unless the mayor chooses to allow us to speak. Okay, now, to me, that's a game of telephone. By the time I get done with one somewhat interpretation from one thing to another, you know, what really was said may not really have been said. By the time it gets to me, it may have been said something a different way. I personally don't think that's to me, it's not the right way of doing things.
Yes, I understand. So going forward.
My recommendation was that anything that has to do with the council and any council business, especially an ordinance, all right, where the ordinance is going to be, where the police are going to be involved with day-to-day enforcement of that ordinance and knowing that we are going to have to pass that ordinance, that there is no reason at all why the council, especially as the council president, should not have any issues or questions or concerns directly from the chief. And it should come directly to us. We should be part of that exchange. So that we are.
So is that allowed in the Faulkner rule of government?
So long as the mayor says it's okay, which I believe right now that we are in that, you know, we're not looking to do day-to-day operation because I'm not going to pick up the phone and say, you know what, hey chief, I think you should put a speed trap on the Camp Road.
But on these issues
where we're looking at, where we're saying, you know, how are we going to enforce this, or is there a better way to enforce this? Mm-hmm. Is there other towns that you know that might be enforcing this way? Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be somewhere where he's blindsided or I'm blindsided, okay, and the council is. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, I think in the way that some of the past has been, some of the things that have happened, you know, where, you know, listen, I'll bring up something that I think is, you know, and if I overstep, the council will tell me to stop.
Well,
we had a situation with rules and recs, okay? The council never even saw the rules and recs. And there was a concern in stating that the council had made comments or this was being brought by the council. The council never had seen those rules and regs. The chief had seen them for 10 days prior to us. Okay, and so again, there was a misinterpretation of where it came from, who it came from, how it got there, and the comments that were being made was not from us. Okay, I think after we had a good meeting then with the PBA, and we sat with the PBA, explained what currently had gone on, and I think that there was a better understanding of where the rules and regs came from, who was, you know, how it got there, and then I think it was better, like I said, it cured some of the issues of where they thought, the PBA had thought at first, of that we were really trying to do that, that it was the council. The council had nothing to do with it. The council didn't even know the rules and regs existed until 10 days after that everyone else had seen them. So part of it is about communication, and that's what I explained earlier. And I think going forward, we want to be on the same page. We all want to be on the same page. And it's very difficult for me when you're not able to.
I see that's, you know, there's hopefully a returning page.
You know, I think it's really important that you have an explanation of what happened with that communication. the council passed an ordinance, and the chief was sent that ordinance because we wanted to design the sign. Theoretically, the chief could tell us if he had any changes or any edits to the sign. That's how it started. And I can go back in the dates. And in the course of that, the chief sent back several times to say that he had issues with how do we enforce this. And he was asked several times of the attorney and of the administration, I have questions that are concerns about exposing our officers to potentially profiling lawsuits. They're very, very serious. I gave back to the state police in the state of New Jersey. They're horrible. And he had deep concerns about the enforcement of it. So back and forth we went, and quite honestly, I don't think anyone here is prepared, the attorney, myself, the administrator, prepared to direct or answer the question, so what do I do in these particular scenarios? But there were valid concerns that the chief expressed over many, many weeks. He didn't get an answer. So his last recourse was, and I believe there was an email.
Who was he looking for?
From myself, from the administrator, and from the attorney.
Okay.
And we didn't have the answers because we simply don't have the answers. We're good, but we're not great at that stuff, right? So when the time came, he had no other option but several days before to go to the Bergen County Prosecutor. Bergen County Prosecutor looked at that ordinance and said it's unenforceable. It's unenforceable to the point that he sent an email, he sent a hard copy letter, and he had a press conference because he suggested that the enforcement of that ordinance, putting up those signs, potentially violate Fourth Amendment rights of civil rights of residents. Then I was asked to put the signs up, and I felt that the signs, putting them up inadvertently, would direct someone, just like we talked about signs, as an instrument that grabs your attention and directs you to do something, that putting up the signs in itself, even though not enforceable, caused the same impact to residents who would come there and make a value judgment and say, I probably shouldn't be here. Much as if you pulled up and saw a stop sign and said, well, I'm going to stop my car. Or if you saw that same stop sign and drove through it, had an accident, and there wasn't an ordinance in place to protect you. So that caused issues. The chief did the right thing by reaching out to his boss of bosses, I no better explanation, the Bergen County Prosecutor, who weighed in. Had that not happened, our entire township would have been subject to some real serious lawsuits, and the officers, there's 51 officers that deserve to go out with real mandates of what are the laws specifically, how do they enforce them, and what discretion they can use. That's what officers do. And without that, constitutional rights covered and everything, it was a problem. In the future, we look back and we say, how could we have made that better? I just wanted to give you that explanation because it's not being told here. Looking back, I think what the council president is saying is, there are ordinances that the ordinance committee creates which really don't interfere with law enforcement from time to time. But there are ordinances that do, like the no-knock ordinance, where the chief of police should theoretically be a part of the process and have his comments and commentary. It fast tracks and gets us before we introduce them. That is the change that you've seen. We're very willing to have that right because we want these ordinances to be right for our community. Well thought out, practical. That is the desire of everyone sitting here. But in this particular case, I believe the prosecutor said the right thing. I believe the chief of police took the appropriate action, and it's all in concert to protect our community and the officers who work for us.
And I just want to emphasize one thing that he said, and that was the point that I had made earlier. He had contacted the administrator, the mayor, and the attorney.
Right.
We are the ones who ended up passing it. Well, when we look to pass this, the assumption is in place of how it's going to be enforced, okay, that this is what goes on. And it's not through an assumption. What I'm saying is the assumption is of the people here in town. When you pass an ordinance, this is what you think is going to happen. That, to me, was the biggest concern. If all four of us, if this is going to be something that's processed that we're going to be involved in, we need to be part of that communication.
Now, does the attorney then get in touch with you? Like, would that have been appropriate?
Well, we all sit down. Usually when we're doing an ordinance committee meeting, all right, we'll sit down and try to get all the issues and say, here's a problem or here's where we're at. I can tell you that as we went through the ordinance committee meeting, there were some concerns that we were that were stated, that there was nothing given to me in writing. I had nothing hard copy of showing of what the issues were, the
the council to sit, the administrator, the mayor, and the attorney knew. But at the same time, you know, we knew that there was concerns, and what, so I had, all I had said at the, you know, ordinance committee meeting with Jonathan then and Jim Weissman is, we need to figure out a solution. We have to have a solution by the time we pass this. So, you know, let's get this done, figure out a way. You know, we pay very good money for law enforcement here in town, and that's not my area of expertise, all right? So the, to me, that's where it should come from.
Right.
It should come from the person who's, you know, on the top to filter it down so that we know. And if there is something that's a concern from there, give us suggestions. Tell us what you need. Tell us what your thoughts are. Explain to us what you would like to have for your men and women to enforce it, or a better way of doing so. I can't do that for you. That's not my, that's not what I do. But at the same time, I'm willing to pass those things so long as we get to the point of we know how it's going to occur at the end, which is the reason why I made the suggestions that we needed to have in place so we don't get to the same place that we ever did at the last time.
Excellent. Okay, thank you very much, and thank you for all your hard work. Appreciate it.
Michael Cohen, and I'm here tonight once again representing the Simon Wiesenthal Center as its East Coast Director. 2 weeks ago, I came here in the hopes that both the governing body of MAWA and the residents that it represents would be open-minded to hearing an alternate perspective on the issue of the day, the controversy between this and your neighboring townships and the Jewish community residing on your borders. 2 weeks ago, after waiting for 2 hours to exercise my legal right to make public comments in an open session to this body, I was heavily censored. I hope it is recognized that when attendees of this meeting speak about celebrating the history here of diversity and tolerance, it is understood that listening to others' perspectives is a large part of that process.
Okay, one second. I'm going to stop you for something now. I'm stopping the timer so this way you can understand. Nobody stopped you from speaking on anything other than the topic that was at hand. We did not, and I will say this one more time, this is not an issue of what you're trying to make it about. This is about plastic poles being placed on our telephone poles without the permission of this council. You and your organization can say whatever you would like to make it, and you try to make it what it is, but to you, it's not. It is not that to this community. It is not that to this council. And for you to sit there and make those comments to me is just wrong. If you have something that you'd like to say in general about what your opinion is, that's fine. But please don't tell us of what we're doing or what your thought or where we are. We're not. What we did was we, as the code official came in tonight and expressed his opinion, is that there were poles put up, PVC pipes on the poles here in the township of Mahwah without the permission of the council. Can we agree on that?
With all due respect,
I'm asking you a question. You asked me, we agree on that was what happened tonight from our code official.
Answer the question.
So the question is, with our code official, the reason why we're looking to enforce the code is because there were PVC pipes put on our poles without our permission. Yes or no?
With all due respect, that is your opinion and you're fully entitled to it. And at a public comment session, I am fully entitled to express my opinion.
And I'm fully entitled that at that point, that if I believe that there is something going to happen, that by your comments are going to put us in a position, knowing that there's potential litigation to go on, that I have my right to shut you down so that my town is not in a position that, based on what you say, puts us in a bad spot. So you have to understand, this is not about shutting you down in your comments. The comments that we're asking you to make is that if you have an opinion on something, that's fine. But please don't tell us or try to put on a record a statement that can be potentially used against us in the future. Is that simple? So I asked you a question you didn't want to answer.
I am entitled to put on a record any comment under public session that I have an opinion to. That's just the law, sir. And I would say, sir, and I would say, very simply, as I said at the last meeting, this is not public discussion period, it's called public comment period. The reason for that is so that, I appreciate if you would stop the timer so I can actually make my comments, and that this is not the comments as your tactic last time to stop me from speaking and telling
you. It's not about tactics. I have provided people here the chance to speak. I have listened to everybody. The difference is that other people, when you come up, you have a comment to make, make the comment. If you have something that you're going to direct towards us to say that we've done something that we haven't done, I'm sorry. That's the idea of the attorney here, is to protect the township. Okay, and that is what our job is, and that is my job as council president, is to protect the township from comments or things that are made that could potentially put us in a situation that's litigious. We live in a litigious society, and I'm sorry, I'm not going to have MAWA be put on and hung on, you know, on a word that's been said here by someone that says something that's not true.
But sir, I would like to say that you are wrong in the law, because anything that I say, as long as it's not responded to, does not expose you to anything in litigation. I am not a party to any litigation. I am not a party to any of these any of those pieces of litigation. I am an individual representing an organization that is making public comments.
Go ahead.
Thank you. By way of background, let me assure the governing body that I am not personally a stranger to either North Jersey or its local systems of governance, or the desire to protect the local quality of life. In addition to my capacity at the center, I also am currently the longest-serving member of the Council of the City of Englewood, just a few short miles from here, and in the same county. Let me assure you that I myself constantly am enmeshed in fighting back from the destruction of our trees, the protection of our charming downtown, and the lobbying of developers who want to change the character of our community. I understand these arguments and would not for one moment ask MAWA to make the sacrifices that I myself have fought back in the city where I live. However, there is a significant distinction in the way that both myself and my local community have fought to preserve our city's character and the how it differentiates it from the actions of MAWA. I stand before you tonight to express serious concern over the manner in which the governing body of the Township of MAWA has approached the situation regarding the construction of the area within the boundaries of your municipality. Let me start by saying that the Simon Wiesenthal Center, along with many of our colleague organizations in the Jewish communal structure...
I'm just going to go on the record. It's not a neighborhood for us. It's PVC pipe. There is no enclosure. It is not enclosed currently in the township. It is not enclosed currently for where it's being built. Therefore, for us in this town, that's what it's been, and I'll say it one more time on the record, it is PVC pipe on poles for us without permission from the township of MAWA. Continue.
Thank you. Let me start by being clear that it's saying that the Simon Wiesenthal Center, along with many of our colleague organizations in the Jewish communal structure, view certain actions taken and pronouncements made by some in these proceedings to be of an anti-Semitic nature. If MAWA's true objective is the quality of life and way of life and protect its way of life, then you certainly have the municipal tools available to accomplish that objective generically. Through your boards of adjustment, planning, and planning boards, you can ensure that no grouping of people can overbuild or overdevelop in your township. From your police traffic bureaus, you can restrict parking limitations and control congestion. From your code enforcement department, you already have the ordinances in place to protect your foliage, natural resources, and anything else that you can imagine. However, by restricting an area, a fundamental religious accommodation necessary for segments of the Jewish population to legally practice their faith in accordance with the biblical statutes.
Sorry, this is not about religion. I'm going to say this one more time. I don't know how many times I can say this. I understand this is your opinion. I get it, but this is not what happened in this town. Okay, that's fact.
That's your opinion.
No, that's fact. There's a difference between what you're saying and what actually did occur.
Sir, we are allowed to have a difference of opinion.
Sir, I'm just going to tell you, it's not what happened. We've stated what happened. The reason why there's an issue here and the reason why Orange and Rockland is involved is because they did not get permission from the township.
Sir, then you should have nothing to fear by me finishing my comments if that is the
case. I have nothing to fear. That's the reason why we went and expressed what we did.
Sir, then you let me finish my comments. Thank you. However, by restricting an era, a fundamental religious accommodation necessary for segments of the Jewish population to legally practice their faith in accordance with biblical statutes, You are, in fact, doing nothing more than saying that Jews are not welcome.
Stop. You crossed the line. You crossed the line.
I'm done with it. I don't know what the attorney's going to tell me or not, but I'm sorry. You're done. Thank you.
Can I have an opinion from the attorney, please?
I gave you my own opinion.
I think that's enough, Mr. Cohen. I mean, to say that the community is now saying that a certain group is unwelcome and accusing the council, that goes over the line.
So I
not to mention that we do have a temple in our town. In fact, there is a large percentage of our population that is Jewish, and there are many people who are in this audience right now that you probably just offended. Thank you.
I would like to
see you in 2 weeks.
I think you should leave. Thank you. You went over the line, sir. You really went over the line. Okay? Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you.
2 weeks ago, I was also prevented from speaking, and before I speak, I do note that your agenda says the public portion is limited to subjects on this agenda. I assume that's why you're cutting off public comment about certain topics.
No, I think if you heard me here, unless you missed it, I said, or anything else you'd like to speak about tonight.
Yes, at the last meeting, that was the stated purpose.
No, the last meeting, the reason why that's done, okay, and I started the timer yet for you, is that there was a reason for us to go through, because we changed a policy to formulate something that was similar to the Board of Education's policy. All we did was, that was something that occurred, you know, a couple of months ago. It's been something that's in place. It seemed to have been working in the Board of Education. We thought that, as you know, knowing that I had worked there, it may work here. That's it, and nothing else, nothing more about anything. So, again, it's a comment that's on the record that's not true.
As Title 10 does state in Section 10:4-12(7A, the relevant part, to a municipal governing body shall be required to set aside a portion of every meeting of the municipal governing body, the length of portion to be determined by a municipal governing body, for public comment on any governmental issue that a member of the public feels may be of public concern to the residents of the municipality.
Okay. So far, we have no problem agreeing. It's a governmental issue, back
yes.
and forth.
Of any concern to the residents of the municipality. Mm-hmm. So my first question is, if you're going to be complying, the statute says, for public comment on any government issue that a member of the public feels may be of concern to residents of the municipality. A member of the public concerned to the residents.
Of the municipality?
Yes.
So that means...
And I'm a member of the public, and I'm speaking of a matter that could be a public concern to the residents of the municipality.
Okay. That's fine. Yeah.
So my first question is whether or not, because your agenda does say that public portion is limited to subjects on the agenda, which seemingly conflicts with statute, is there another portion of the meeting where I can speak on any topic that's in addition to the agenda, or is this the...
Basically, the council president, it's his prerogative of the council president, is also to change, and I've said it once, and I've said it twice, therefore, just because it's on the way what we follow protocol on that, does not necessarily mean that we can change it. We did, we stated that for, you know, to do that, that this should be on anything on the agenda before. I even stated that it would be that there were things that were tabled on the first public portion that you were here for.
Yes.
But I said that I would allow people to come up, because I know that they had come out, to speak on certain issues. Nothing's changed any different than that, so you can proceed.
The last time I was here, I wanted to speak about the enforcement of a zoning ordinance that has to deal with AROOFs, how sign ordinances are construed, how the Third Circuit Court of Appeals deals with them. The Third Circuit said, if anything, The lefties are less of a problem because they're so unobtrusive. Even observant Jews are often unable to distinguish them from ordinary utility wires. And while the borough, this was Tenafly, alleges that they are different because the plaintiffs intend them to be permanent, like house numbers nailed to utility poles are likewise intended to be permanent. And although the borough insists the lefties are religious, nature justifies its decision to remove them, this is precisely the sort of reasoning that Lukumi and Fraternal Order of Police forbid. So my question is how your current ordinance deals with them, and specifically related to the OPMA violations that took place in your last meeting, how you are going to deal with the fact that in light of your own agenda, which is posted on your website, restricting comments in seeming violation of statute, how you are going to deal with an OPMA violation that could nullify ordinances that are passed at a meeting. But I want to get past that for a second.
Well, you can get past it all you want to, but the bottom line is that we have stated to you that we can change prerogative here. This is what we chose. It's on the agenda. We stated at the second public portion, and we are on the record on this, that we could all go in and it would be on any topic. Why that may be listed there or whatever, but I made sure that I put forth so that everyone knew that you could talk about anything you wanted in the second public portion. So.
Sir, I just wanted to also add that if you read the agenda, the paragraphs for both public portions, you can clearly see that the first public portion is, you know, agenda items, whereas this public portion, which you are in right now, is exactly...
Jonathan, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but there's a typo.
Yeah, read it.
Sorry.
No, but that was the reason why I made the correction before the public portion started, that it would be on this or anything, because I saw that it was there. And which is the reason why we stated at the second public portion. So when I noticed that, I stated that this could be this or anything else, because you know what? Erasers are pencils for a reason. All right? Not everybody makes, you know, we're not going to be perfect on everything we do, but I made sure that when I noticed the mistake, that we put it on here so that it would be brought forth so that anybody can speak on
respectfully,
topic, which is what I'm allowing.
Respectfully, that may carry more weight if I was not cut off the last time I tried to speak by raising a legitimate objection about a zoning decision in regards to enforcement of a zoning ordinance.
Well, the reason why is that if you remember why you're, because we had mentioned directly before the meeting the things were not going to be discussed.
You don't have that right.
Well, you can tell me anything you want to, and I understand that's your opinion and mine. And you can come to my meeting.
You have a lawyer sitting next to you. Why don't you ask him?
Well,
I'll give you it. The First Amendment is not an unfettered right.
I am not speaking to the First Amendment, sir.
And therefore, there can be limits imposed by the council, both in time and place, as to what can and can't be said.
Is that your opinion under the Open Public Meetings Act?
Yeah, that's my opinion under the Open Public Meetings Act, and based upon other case law that has come out and statements made at meetings. And therefore, it can be restricted and it can be controlled. We may disagree, but that's what can happen. No one is preventing you from speaking here. We may or may not agree. And there was a mistake on the agenda that it said that it would be limited to agenda items. The policy was changed by this council several meetings ago that the agenda items would be the first session and the second session on restricted.
You know, as the vice chairman of the planning board in my town, I'm not only familiar with the Open Public Meetings Act, with sign ordinances, with the type of ordinances and sign codes that you're dealing with at issue here. But I also know the public responsibility that's vested in meetings like these. It was deeply disturbing from a civic standpoint to see elected representatives showing the disdain that was showed last meeting for opinions that the public wanted to reach that are clearly within the statute for opinions of public concern affecting issues residents want to deal with. Now, one of the things I wanted to speak to regarding the parks ordinance was a case, and the mayor alluded to New Jersey State Police. There's a case that goes back way further, and the attorney may be familiar with Wick Hobie Hopkins, where in California they had, and the Supreme Court stated, that racially discriminatory application of a racially neutral statute, your statute has nothing to do with Jews, violates the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment. The Supreme Court ruled on that. And in that case, they were dealing with laundromats that disproportionately affected Chinese residents. Here, we have a situation where the people in the parks are Jews. We have...
No. I'm going to stop that. The people in the park come from New York. That's what the issue was.
Yes, and the Chinese came from California, but they were Jews.
Listen, you, again, your opinion is your opinion.
That's what I'm stating here.
Well, I'm stating with the reasonings why we sat down, and I was the one, along with the ordinance committee, who went through this process of what we were being told. What we were being told was that we were being overrun by cars with New York plates on them, that our kids could not be able to use our own swings and our own slides. Now, that may be different than what you want it to be, but I'm telling you what we developed the ordinance because of. And again, it may not meet what you want it to be, and it may not be the grand story and the big thing and the big newspaper article and the big thing for anything else that you want to put out there right now, or your Facebook post and the attacks on us. But you know what? That's the truth. Whether you like it or not, it's the truth. This is what our township is. Our township deserves. We pay the taxes for that swing and for that slide. Our people maintain that. Our DPW go in there. Just like in your town, that you have your own parks that have your people there to go in there and your residents. Nobody tells you, the township of Teaneck, in fact, I do not see one member of this audience that goes down to Teaneck and tell you how to handle your parks, do they? So you know what? I find it very odd that someone comes in here to our community to let us know to attack this board, to attack this town, to attack our residents, because you're going to tell me that what we did was we went in to make sure that our residents came first in the park that they paid their taxes for?
Sir.
I'm sorry.
Sir.
Excuse me. You're wrong.
Sir.
You're wrong. You're wrong.
You think so. You think so. What is happening here is that a group, and some of your parks have taken Green Acres funding, which cannot ban residents from Teaneck or Englewood or any other resident of New Jersey under law, which you can check with your attorney from entering your
office.
But
if you look, if it said, if you read the ordinance said New Jersey resident. The ordinance did not say he
your
got anybody from
chief
anywhere
of
else.
Police found this fundamentally flawed from an enforcement standpoint.
Yeah, enforcement, not
yes.
law. And the prosecutor didn't find anything wrong with the law either. Did you notice that? He didn't go in there and rule on the law. He told them, he didn't say there was anything problem with the law. The problem was the enforcement. I would tell you, I promise you this. You can come to the next meeting or the one after or the one where it is. I promise you, there will be a park ordinance and there will be one that is going to be enforceable in this town. Whether you like it or not.
When the Supreme Court... violation, they found it on a neutral ordinance that is still illegal. If it is operating and enforcing in a non-neutral manner, you cannot do it.
Well,
and
it's funny because Clarkstown is doing it, Stony Point is doing it, Upper Saddle River is doing it, Ramsey has one on. I could go through the area. I could go through every town. Orangetown has one on too, a park ordinance. Somehow, they're all working there. And you know what? I don't see you in any of those other meetings telling them or attacking those towns on what their port ordinance is or why they're enforcing the way they are. You know what? Maybe I'll give you the schedule. You can go visit them also. The bottom line is we will have an ordinance in place for our town to do what needs to be done for our port ordinance because the residents here in our town should come first. Just like when I have the issue, when I took Mawa residents first to speak, there's a reason. This is about their town first, okay? And just like it may be your issue because of what you think is a concern and what the issue is, that's fine. That is not our issue. That is not what we're talking about. It may be to you, and I'm sorry that that's the way you feel, but that's not the way this board feels, it's not the way this town feels, and it's not the way our residents feel.
Can I agree with you on something before I leave? Can I agree with you on something before I leave?
Yes.
I agree with you that it is very difficult to stop rumors from spreading, and I hope, just like I got an answer from this town, that there were no official complaints lodged with police or officials about people knocking on doors, that you would try to stop some of those rumors from spreading by giving the public as much information as you can at all times.
I agree with you on that.
I agree very much.
I agree.
My name is Vince Crandon. I proudly live in Mahwah, New Jersey. I gave someone else the chance to speak before me. That was your decision, but I promised everybody I wasn't going to say a word tonight. I was just here, so I don't have anything prepared. I'm not reading from anything. I don't have a script. This comes from my heart. I've tried in good faith, behind the scenes, to try and handle everything very quietly, very diplomatically, with a lot of different people. And a lot of people are up on this dais right now. And it offends me when someone comes to this meeting and disrespects any resident of Mahwah. And I know Mr. Cohen, okay? And I respect what he's trying to do, but to come to this town in this forum today and to insult me as a resident of Mahwah is completely, 100%, I won't tell you my true opinion, but I will certainly call you about it tomorrow. It's not in the spirit of what we discussed. We're trying to do harmony. Our biggest problem here, and it's even demonstrated tonight, is Mahwah is a township of rules and regulations. It has nothing to do with religion. We don't have an A-roof in Mahwah. They made it an A-roof. We don't have such a thing. We have a bunch of ugly pole attachments. They're PVC pipes. The law says, guess what? You can't do that. Now, everybody feels that we need to make accommodations and bend down and speak to basically criminals, okay? You violate a law, you're a criminal, okay? If I do it, I'm not going to negotiate with a police officer if he pulls me over and says, hey, you know, let's talk about it. Let's table it for 2 weeks. I'm going to get a ticket. And I'm sure the Mahwah police, here we are, 11:45. Unfortunately, they left the building.
They're here.
Well, thankfully, and I'm sure the Mahwah police, if I had a speeding ticket, we're not going to talk about it. And I love Mahwah police, but I'll tell you, that's why I love them. Because they enforce the laws. We have a law on the book. Someone came in here. I don't care who it is. I don't care what religion it is. They came into this community. It's a thief in the night with nobody's knowledge, nobody approval, and put a bunch of ugly PVC pipes. Now, I heard a previous comment, oh, you don't notice them. Well, guess what? If that gentleman would like to come up to me and look at my cell phone, I've got pictures of these white, ugly PVC things. And I guarantee you, no one will say, hey, I didn't know what that is. I don't know what that is. I know what it is. And everybody, if you care to see how ugly these white things are on our telephone poles, I'll be happy to sit down and show you. But let's get back to the core matters here. This is a matter of law. Laws have been broken. Laws must be enforced. While I appreciate everybody's accommodation, Mr. Mayor, certainly the council, and everybody bending over backwards to try and accommodate, in essence, a criminal act. That's what's been basically done here, putting up something that is against our codes. I don't care who you are. You broke the law, okay? We're trying to be nice, and I applaud the mayor, and there's a lot of things that happen behind the scenes where we like to resolve things as civil people. And I personally have been involved in it, so I give the mayor a lot of credit. But I think what has happened is we've been insulted. Our town has been insulted. It's been in the media. We're anti-Semitic. We're this. We're that. We've declared war. We've done this. I am tired of it. I live here. I'm proud I live here. And up until this time, we had a very peaceful, loving community. But I will, and I appreciate your council and everyone here taking a final position, putting it into the sand, guess what? As of 18th of August, the law's the law. We're done talking. We don't negotiate with criminals. A former president said something a little bit higher. I'm not going to go there. But we don't negotiate with criminals. I am not expecting to negotiate with a police officer if I get a ticket, or if somebody from the township knocks on my door and says, you know what? You got paint peeling from your house. Fix it. If not, we're going to give you a ticket. So why should we sit here and listen to all kinds of excuses from people that have violated our laws? These are our laws. These are people coming in from New York who who suddenly think, well, okay, for one reason or another, we're going to take a boundary that's in New York, and because we want to walk around, we're going to establish this imaginary exodus way out of God's law to say, hey, we're going to put this string and wire up, and guess what? God's gone. We get up to see our maker, and God's suddenly going to say, I appreciate it, but look, I'm not going to go that way. I just circle back to the point that this is nothing but a matter of law. Violations have occurred, people have comments, and people are saying things that are way out of context, and I'm appreciative as a Mahwah resident, we're finally going to enforce our ordinances. Thank you.
Thank you.
Deirdre Wilson, Tennessee Dan Court, Mom, Jersey, obviously. But I lived in Mom for 45 years, and I got up because I was deeply offended by the gentleman from the human rights. That's where you represent people, it's human rights. I have rights too, as we all do in Ma, and I just want to thank the town council and Mr. Hermanson for really sticking up for the people of Mahwah. And really, you know, all the bad press, all the articles that are completely one-sided, and no one takes the time to ask any residents what we think. Or, you know, I live at the right by the park at Seacourse, and you know, I'm nice to anyone that's there, as are most people that are there. But, you know, the things that you're creating, and there are people knocking on our doors where I live. So it's happening, and it's not okay that people are parked cars or whatever. But things are happening. So yes, some things aren't true, but a lot are true. And I just want to thank you guys, because you really represented our concerns, and you are standing up for the people of Mahwah. We have rights too, and we need to be heard. And everything we say completely gets turned into this ugliness. People coming from other towns to say these terrible things about us. I have a problem with that. You know, take some time to talk to me about my town. I've been here for 45 years. Ask me some questions. Put that in your article. I coach in town. I love this town. And I really just want to thank you all for all the hard work that you've done to look out for the people of Mahwah. And we can't thank you enough. And I'm going to tell everyone that wasn't here what a great job you did tonight looking out for us, saying everything straight to what it is. PVC pipe and where the concerns are and everything. I just really appreciate it, and I feel really proud to be a Mahwah resident, and I'm thankful to raise my boys in this great town, hopefully grandchildren someday. So I just wanted to thank you for all that you do, and all the hours and hours and hours that you put in to looking out for us, for the people of Mahwah, and doing what's right for us. So thank you so much. I appreciate it.
To ordinance 1813, which is an ordinance for determining positions eligible for the defined contribution retirement program. Motion to introduce.
So moved.
By Mr. Wong. Second by. I'll second it. Roll call.
Mr. Raymond?
Yes.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Yes.
Mr. Wong?
Yes.
Mr. Wattati?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
How
much? Motion to open to the public.
So moved.
Second.
By Mr. Wong, second by Mr. May. All in
favor?
Aye.
Anyone who'd like to speak about the ordinance, strictly on this ordinance to amend the municipal ordinance for 1798 salary ordinance amendment, please come forward. Seeing no one, motion to close.
So moved.
By Mr. Urban, second by Mr. Wong. All in favor?
Aye.
Roll call.
Ms. Arima?
Yes.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Yes.
Mr. Wong?
Yes. What is this? This is the adoption? Could we make a motion?
Did I make the motion or not? Motion? Motion to adopt the ordinance.
So.
So second, first by Mr. Urban, second by Mr. Wong. Roll call.
Okay, Ms. Arima?
Yes.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Yes.
Mr. Wong?
Yes.
Mr. Wazaki?
Yes.
Mr. Hermanson?
Yes, been a long night, sorry.
It's fine.
Okay.
Now we need a motion.
Now motion for 1810 and 1811 have been tabled. 1812, make a, Mr. Wong?
Is to be tabled also, there are additional comments that were made, and we'll discuss them at the ordinance committee meeting. So I believe Mr. Wong would like to make that motion.
So moved. No, a motion to table 1812 for further discussion at the ordinance committee meeting to the department head changes.
Second.
Okay, roll call.
Ms. Arima?
Yes.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Yes.
Mr. Wong?
Yes.
Mr. Wazaki?
Yes.
Mr. Hermanson?
Yes. Okay, consent agenda. Does anybody have anything on the consent agenda they would like to pull? Seeing no one and saying anything, I'd like to move the consent agenda to 89. We also have to add 296, I believe, for the acceptance of the rain garden, correct? We have to do it here. We just had to be removed. But, so we have to add 296. Put that on there. I'll sign it tomorrow or the next year for that. And motion to move the consent agenda to 296. Okay.
Second.
Yes, sir.
By Mr. Wysocki. Roll call.
All right. Ms. Arima?
Yes.
Mr. Urban?
Yes.
Mr. May?
Yes.
Mr. Wong?
Yes.
Mr. Wysocki?
Yes.
Mr. Hermanson?
Yes. Okay, any old business?
I had a quick question. When are we going to do the new rebid for the garbage? Right, garbage?
Well, that's going to be in February. Like I said,
well, I thought we were doing something.
We plan to put it out right around later.
Okay.
Yeah. We've sent letters. We sent letters out to all the condo associations and a couple apartment buildings, and so they're on notice.
Any feedback on it?
I got one call from the condo association. I tried returning the call. I left a message. Didn't get a call back. So they had gotten a letter. They called up the message saying they just had a question or two. And
right.
Anyhow, I never heard again. I did call though same day and left a message.
Okay.
Okay.
Anybody else? Any new business? I tried so
hard. You got your rain garden.
I won't be long.
Okay. I've heard that before too.
Good to talk.
Yeah.
All right. Well, this council is always putting in resolutions about water and things like that. And I'm referring to an article I see in the paper about our air. The governor of New Jersey has, taken New Jersey out of the lawsuits where the attorney generals are filing legal challenges because they're delaying Obama-era rules reducing emissions of smog causing air pollutants. So the problem I have with this is that, we're having resolutions about clean water. Can we maybe think about making a resolution about clean air in New Jersey and somehow going to the state and saying that we care about our air in New Jersey and that we think that the state of New Jersey should be joining with the other attorney generals that are suing to enforce the laws that we have to keep our air clean. So can we look into that maybe?
What's 5 to 12 inches is possible?
8.
Anything's possible.
Can we maybe put it on the agenda or something?
I guess anything's possible. We have to look and see what that is and where it's valued. I mean, listen, just because it's on an opinion page in the record.
It's not on an opinion page in the record. It's not an opinion page. It's a fact.
Yeah, the back of it. Like I said, it's on an opinion page.
No.
I don't think what the record says these days, I wouldn't use it for, you know, birdcage feed.
We have dropped out of about 3 different lawsuits and that are about 10 states or 12 states that are in it, and we keep dropping out.
See what the reasonings are. We'll take a look at it. I'll be honest. See what the reasonings are. Why we dropped out, what the thoughts were. If it makes sense, we can put it on. If not, then maybe drop that for the right reasons. I don't know.
Well,
it's 5 to 12, and I just saw this. So.
Okay. Well, okay. I'm going to give you this.
Great. We'll make a copy of it so you can have it.
You can read it tonight.
I'm not reading it tonight.
Well,
okay.
I still think
good luck with that.
I think that clean air is just as important as clean water, and that we should be protecting the air if we can. And if it's something simple like having a little resolution.
I just told you that I would do this right. Okay, you don't have to keep. All right, we're there.
Okay.
Good. Anything else? Okay. Closed session. Motion to go into closed session?
So moved.
By Mr. Urban, second?
Second.
By Mr. Closed session meeting statement. Whereas the Township Council Model deems it necessary to discuss certain actions under Section 10:4-12b-7 on the Open Public Meetings Act statement privately as prescribed by law. Now, therefore, be resolved that at 11:58 p.m., the Township Council combined works.